This video gives the user a quick overview of what HyperLynx DRC does and how to correctly set up a project in it. Once the layout of the board is completed, you should run HyperLynx DRC rules to identify signal integrity, power integrity, and EMI problems that might exist in the board layout. Some of the EMI and EMC issues cannot be identified by simulation software. HyperLynx DRC ensures reliability of your design. Let's try to understand how HyperLynx DRC fits in your design flow. Once the layout is completed, we can import the design to HyperLynx DRC. It's important to make sure that the design data, such as stackup, components, etc., has been imported correctly. Then run a few rules with limited scope and view the violations. If you have any setup issues causing the violations, fix those first. Step by step, increase the number of rules and the scope of those rules. All the violations can be recorded in the form of share lists or spreadsheets. Run simulations on the violations that you might want to investigate a bit further. Go back to the layout, fix errors, and run HyperLynx DRC again. Here are some of the guidelines to avoid false violations. All the built-in rules have a slide that explains what the rule does and what causes violations. Make sure you read and understand those before running the rule. Only enable the rules that are appropriate for your design. Make sure that prerequisites are met for each rule. If not, you might get setup errors. Gradually enable more rules and slowly increase the scope of each rule in order to avoid confusion. To see how to correctly set up project, this video uses the example of aspen.cibd design file, which is included in the software installation. Once the design is opened in HyperLynx DRC tool, it processes the design and creates additional data such as object lists, etc. Object lists represent groups of specific design objects, such as capacitors or physical nets, that the rules use during analysis. After design processing, HyperLynx DRC opens the project setup wizard to help you configure the project in many ways, such as how the software recognizes different design objects, setting rule parameters, and then choosing which of the rules to run. The wizard is a tree structure, and we can access any page within it at random. If not altered, the wizard will use default values to complete the setup. Hit Finish to close the wizard. We can open it anytime by clicking on the Start Project Setup button. Verify that the software has correctly recognized the components. For example, C1 is recognized as a capacitor. If there is a problem with the component identification, it may be because you use a different naming convention. In the properties, we can see that any component that has only two pins and a reference designator that starts with a C is classified as a capacitor. You can add or change to these conditions according to your naming conventions. Verify the stackup has been imported correctly in the tool. By expanding the stackup data in Project Explorer, you can edit or view properties for each layer in the stackup. Once you're done with setting up your project, you can learn about object lists and running rules in the next video.